Hello students, how are you all? Welcome to Smart World, a school of complete education. Today, we are going to learn English Chapter 3, which is an autobiography of a great Indian bustard by Dr. Pramod Patil. Do you know what is an autobiography? Well, if you don't know, then let me tell you, an autobiography is a self-written story of a thing or an animal or a person by himself. So here, Indian bustard, which is a bird, narrates its story to us himself. Let's read it. Which is the heaviest flying bird in India? Well, friends, it's me, the great Indian bustard. I feel proud to be known as the great Indian bustard. I have more than 30 different names in various Indian languages. In Marathi, I am known as Maldhok or Hoom. I can weigh up to 18 kilos and can stand up to 4 feet in height, reaching up to your shoulders or even higher. I have got a long white neck, brown wings, tall yellow legs, and a black cap on my head. My wife, Mrs. Bustard, is smaller and slimmer than I am, and her neck is not white. But I have heard humans say that we both look impressive. I live on the grasslands and deserts along with my other friends, including Chinkara, blackbuck, and larks. I eat everything, including snakes, lizards, small fruits, and berries, and all sorts of insects. That's a very healthy habit, huh? But grasshoppers and beetles are my favorite food items. When it starts raining, we all gather our favorite grasslands where there are no people to disturb us. I perform a wonderful dance by gulping air in the special feathery pouch attached below my neck. This pouch helps me to produce a resonating sound similar to the one produced by the cow. Hmm. I dance in joy with puffed out feathers and cocked up tail and drop down wings. It helps me to impress my soulmate. You know that we birds lay eggs and our young ones hatch out of eggs. Mother Gibb lays just one egg directly on the ground. We don't believe in building nests, but we have a special trick to protect our eggs from predators. The egg looks like a stone. Monitor lizards, foxes, dogs, pigs, snakes, and eagles are enemies of my egg and chick. But my wife protects the egg from all of them. By the time a young one hatches out of the egg, rain arrives. There's plenty of grass swarming with insects, fresh food for my family. Young ones of other birds soon fly away from the nest, but a great Indian bustard mother and chick stay together for nearly 1 year. The chick learns many good habits from the mother. You may have heard about a great human friend of ours, Dr. Salim Ali. He had even suggested that we should be given the status of the national bird of our country. But the honor went to our beautiful relative, the peacock. I am happy to tell you that I am the state bird of Rajasthan. We have got 10 sanctuaries for our protection, but sadly, our number is still going down. We used to live in all parts of India, but slowly the growing population of man pushed us away from more than 90% of our home regions. We are afraid of hunters that kill us for fun. We also die due to electric power lines that we can't see while flying. We are losing our homes. Today, only the last 200 of us are left in the world. We need your support and your love in order to survive. Can you help us? You can write letters to your leaders and make an appeal to help us. You can make my drawing and submit it to your teacher. You can discuss this with your parents. Come to see us at a sanctuary, because now we will not see us in other places. And who knows, if humans don't help us, none of us will be left on the earth. You will only see us in pictures. Help us. So that was about the story, which here are some difficult words which you might know. Pouch. Here it means a pocket-like space. Resonating means producing a loud, clear and deep sound. Predators, animals that hunt, kill and eat other animals. Questions which you should practice. Question number 1. Read the passage aloud. 2. You are going to meet a great Indian bustard very soon. Prepare at least 10 questions to interview him. 3. Play the roles of an interviewer and a great Indian bustard and present the interview in the classroom. 4. Write a letter to your friend about the great Indian bustard. You may use the following points. Why we need to protect the bird? What you plan to do to help the bird? 5. Form pairs and decide whether the following statements are those of a great Indian bustard or not. I'll speak out the statement and you decide whether it's said by the great Indian bustard or not. You'll be able to answer if you have heard the story quite concentratedly. A. I am the heaviest flying bird in India. B. I am known as Maldhook or home in Marathi. C. I live in mountain regions. D. I don't like grasshoppers or beetles. E. We don't believe in building nests. F. Our chick stays with the mother for a period of nearly 1 year. G. I am the state bird of Maharashtra. H. We have been pushed away from more than 90% of our home regions. 6. With the help of the internet and other sources, obtain more information about the critically endangered birds and animals in India. Find the names of their sanctuaries. Some critically endangered birds and animals in India. CR or critically endangered birds or animals are those that are likely to become extinct in the wild. We may never see them again. Some of them are forest owlet, Indian vulture, Siberian crane, Deolali minnow fish, Asiatic cheetah, Himalayan wolf, Amboli toad. Question number 7. Prepare a poster on the need for conservation of the great Indian bustard. 8. Write a short autobiography of any bird or animal of your choice. 9. Make a list of the channels available on your TV under the following categories: news, entertainment, sports, movies, music, etc. Which are the channels on which you can watch programs on animals, wildlife, conservation of environment, etc.? Question number 10. Ask your parents to show you TV programs on animals, wildlife and conservation on channels like the following: DD National, National Geographic, Discovery and Animal Planet. 11. You have won a prize to visit a wildlife sanctuary or national park in Africa or Australia. Choose a location, read about it. Imagine that you are visiting it and write a letter to your friend about it. 12. Language study. Identify the following from the list given in the box below: 4 nouns, 4 verbs, 4 adjectives, 4 adverbs and 4 pronouns. You have to pick 4 of them each. Bird, wonderful, friends, gather, humans, we, I, healthy, grasslands, healths, directly, protect, arrive, together, away, happy, slowly, afraid, you, us. That's it for the chapter. Thank you all.